Okay, hi there. This is the second part of the tutorial for creating a wing in FreeCAD. I have the first part was the wing was already finished, but there was some bad thing here at the end of the wing, and I've created two other lines here. And I have dimensions them with this. These are the length of these lines, and or this. These two are this, this and this, and this here are the X coordinates, and these both here the Z coordinates. These are the X coordinates I've measured here. So I close this sketch and this is a wing now as a what's the name in English? It's a fixolid. It's looking good and I now want to try to put in ribs into this. I must say it's no easy task to do this because there are so many things you have to look for that the ribs can be created completely. This is due to FreeCAD's inability to create multiple objects from a difference calculation. Fusion can do this, but in FreeCAD you have to look for the cutting object if everything is working. So I hope I get it this time, but don't get angry when you try to do this and it does not function. It's no easy task. Okay, I start. I've here the skin, I've named it skin of the wing, and here's the body. I create a new body from this. And there it is. Skin is invisible, and this is named inner. It's inside of the wing. And it's a filled wing, not this skin as we have seen before. So now for the things to make, I need to create a cutting object that cuts out rectangles out of the swing so the ribs will stay. Let's try, let's create this. Okay, I'll create a new body and this one is called whip cutter. And inside this I create a sketch on the X, Z plane and I create it very big. So completely around this wing and not too small. Now I can close this sketch. I create a pad out of this. Let's say it's 1 millimeter in size. It's now lying inside of this wing, so I can select it, transform it, and look how much we need to put it to bottom. Okay, that looks good. I can close this here and now we create a new sketch on the top of it. Select it and this sketch will be located here. I draw a rectangle there. I don't use this rectangle function, I'll use this polygon function. It's a This is the polygon with 5 endpoints. So now I tell it, okay, this and this, this gets an angle of 90 degrees. All lines get the same size. This is parallel, this and this is parallel, that's parallel, and this angle here should be 45 degrees. So the size is of this is 30 millimeters. Now I choose a position for this. I can tip it here. And let's see. Okay. Perhaps a bit more here. Okay. So I close it and create a pad out of this sketch. It gets the length of 50 millimeters. So it's completely covering the wing. I will have a look from the side. Is it working? Yes, everything looks good. So I tell first the thing to save it. I use a new file name. And now we need to create a multiple, what's the name of it here, multiple transform feature. And I want to translate this in this direction and this in this direction. And so cut out this blocks out of this wing. So select it, create the multiple transform. And here we add, I've forgotten something as always. This sketch needs two other lines. I create them in the blue color, construction lines. They also have here an angle of 45 degrees, not 90 degrees, 90 degrees. And this line is also here, not 90, not 45, 135 degrees. These are the lines I need for the multiple transform. Okay, go back here and add a linear pattern and I tell where to go. It's construction line 1. Does not seem to function, so I delete it and try another time. Hello. Okay, start over. There we have our first pad, add a linear pattern with construction line 1. It's the wrong direction, so reverse direction, and the length should be 19 multiplied with 30.4 millimeters. 0.4 millimeters is the size of the whips I need. 19, it's because I want to create 20 copies, and these are the differences, 19 multiplied with 30.4. So this was the first thing. I go to the linear pattern, or add another linear pattern, and this is the construction line 2. This is a y direction. I use the same difference, so it's 19 multiplied with 30.4 millimeters. Okay, look on it, looks good to me. So now I create the first multiple copies 20 times. This will work very fast. Here it is. But the next one, we need to wait some time for it. So you will see a clock telling that it will take a while. Okay, this calculation did now find an end. It took, I think, about 10 minutes or longer. I don't have looked at the clock when I started it. And now you have these amount of blocks here. And these blocks, they have all here a difference from each other, or from of 0.4 millimeters. So now it's time to make everything visible. So the inner wing, it's not visible. So I set the appearance of this to transparent, about 50%, and I do the same for the whip cutter, and now I have both parts visible from each side. Now we have to look if there are problematic cuts inside this of this whip cut here. So what are problematic cuts? Okay, the when you cut such things here out, it may happen that you have whips that are separated, and these separated whips, they cannot be calculated by FreeCAD. So we have here two parts at this. This is the first whip that is not connected to other whips, and at this side you have it here. And these smart whips, they must be deleted. I can do this by adding another polygon here and here. Extruded to as a pad to 50 millimeters, and then these whips will get cut out. But there may be other whips that are separated. Here in this part, it's not possible for such things. But here at the top, you can see, okay, no, these are all connected. Okay. So I will create here another thing. I close this function here and select this plane and create I'm inside body whip cutter, it's correct, and add a sketch here. It shows it this way, okay, will of course work. Set this here to normal drawing mode. This is this, not blue. Create a polygon and same mistake as I have done before. This is wrong. I delete this sketch and I create another body first, and this body gets the name it's correct. Don't know. Okay, this body can be deleted. Whip cutter. I think it's that slow as seen. So, create the drawing here. Here we have it, and we create a new polygon here, there, and to this point. And I do the same for this side here, from there to there, and there. Now I close this sketch and I create another pad here, by here or by here. And this pad, let's have a look, where is it created? Should be created here. And give it a dimension of 50 millimeters. Now see it there, how it is created at this side and at this side. And okay. And a whip cutter and inner wing are now to be Boolean manipulated. So I choose the inner wing, click somewhere outside of the object, take this Boolean operation here, change it to cut, and select a body, and this body is the whip cutter. And now some time to wait. Was not too long the waiting time, and you see the whips are created as they should be. This is not the result every time, because when you don't see problematic cutouts here in this case, it won't function, and it's not easy to see these problematic cutouts. Okay, but in this case it worked very good, so I create put the skin over it. The skin is also I will first I must press OK. I think we have another waiting time here. Okay, here I have my wing with the internal ribs. I now can change the appearance for this here also to transparent, and the inner things are transparent, and you can see how these ribs are inside of this wing. Okay, this is the end of the second tutorial. In the next tutorial I will try to put in holes for, I don't know the name for it, Holme, it's in German, and cut out for the ailerons. Perhaps a cutout for a servo. I don't know how far I can get in the next tutorial. Okay. Hope you enjoyed this, and many thanks, and have fun with FreeCAD. Bye.